Hi, I'm Snigdha Sharma and you're listening to Three Things, the Indian Express News Show. In this episode, we discuss the latest exclusive two-part investigative series by Indian Express's Shyamlal Yadav. The investigation involved the examination of more than 100 PSUs or public sector undertakings. Now, as you know, a PSU is a government-owned enterprise. These companies are wholly or partly owned by the Government of India or one of the many state governments or both together in parts. At the beginning of the 21st century, India and China had three PSUs each in the Fortune 500. Fast forward to about two decades later, now India is still stuck with three PSUs in the Fortune 500 while China has 43. One of the many reasons for this stagnation could be what Indian Express found through its investigation. That of the 172 independent directors in 98 PSUs, half are linked to the ruling BJP. And it's not just politicians linked to the BJP who have been made independent directors. The second part of the investigation by Indian Express revealed that retired bureaucrats are favored for this post too. So to understand the importance of this investigation better, we spoke to the man himself, Shyamlal Yadav. So Shyamlal, if you can begin by explaining to us, what is the importance of independent directors in public sector undertakings in India?
In fact, independent directors, what they do, they are not part of their day-to-day business of any PSU, but their role is as important as of any other director. So they play a key role in their policy planning, they influence their functioning, their management in many ways. Presently, as per the Companies Act, it's mandatory to appoint independent directors, and there is a criteria for different companies that what type of company, how many independent directors it will have. In fact, the purpose of independent directors, the word independent is sufficient to explain their role, okay? So you can understand why it's called independent director. Means he or she must be independent from the any control, any relation with that particular company. That should be the ideal situation. So that was the purpose, I suppose, when it is called independent director. But what is happening now, and I will focus on my findings only. I scrutinized, in fact, around 150, means 146 PSUs independent directors I scrutinized. I found that 98 public sector undertakings, they have 172 independent directors, and exactly 50%, means 86 of them, they were directly related to BJP. There were a number of office bearers of the BJP in national team or state teams, and number of different type of responsibilities they have been assigned by the BJP. So question is that if they are member of ruling party, so how they can be called independent? Means because the major stake in these companies, you can understand it is with Government of India. That is why they are called public sector companies. Then I found number of retired bureaucrats of like there is one ministry, and under the administrative control of that particular ministry, there are some PSUs. One officer retires from the secretary of that ministry, and within a year or few years or few months, he or she is appointed as independent director of the PSU under that particular ministry. So this is, I think, some sort of conflict of interest that, and this must be addressed by the governments and policymakers.
Right. So can you explain the hiring process or protocol for independent directors?
First, a search committee is constituted in the chairmanship of a secretary of Government of India, of a department. And it has two secretaries, other members. One is from the administrative ministry of that particular PSU. Then there are two members outside. So mostly it's a five-member search committee. They recommend the panel of names, and the process is that the administrative ministry finally appoints these independent directors, but final consent, final approval is taken by the appointment committee of the cabinet, which is headed by Honorable Prime Minister of India. So ACC means Appointment Committee of the Cabinet finally gives the approval of appointment of any independent director of central public sector undertaking.
Right. So what were the biggest findings or takeaways from your investigation?
The first thing was that 50% politicians are there. It's already I told you. Second thing I found that number of officers retired from, like you see one first person I published in the bureaucrat story, second part of the story, a secretary of textile ministry, Mr. Panda, he retires from there. And there is PSU under that particular ministry. And after retirement, he is appointed independent director there. And you can understand that being secretary is head of the any department. After the minister, he looks after everything. You know that. So if he is monitoring that particular PSU as a secretary of the administrative department, and after the retirement, he or she is appointed independent director of that PSU. So I think it's a matter of conflict of interest. And these things must be addressed by the government. And I must tell you that this is not happening for the first time in India. Earlier, the Indian Express itself, I was not with the Indian Express that time. Our investigative team had, Ms. Ritu Sareen published that story in May 2007, that UPA government under Dr. Manmohan Singh ji, they appointed, there were that time as per her story published in Indian Express, that time there were 37 independent directors in public sector banks, and 33 of them were associated to ruling Congress party that time, and number of them were some All India AICC secretary, vice president, and several state teams. So different type of offices they were holding in the Congress, and they all appointed independent directors in public sector banks. Similarly, the situation was in other public sector undertakings also. So it has like become a tradition that every ruling party appoint their leaders to various PSUs as independent director. When a country has a long list of professionals of every field, every sector, so why they can't be appointed as independent directors whom we can purely call independent? So second finding was these bureaucrats, and of course there were a number of professionals which we did not publish, but there are good professionals also whose list is separate. That was not story was first on the politicians and second on the retired bureaucrats. Bureaucrats from every sector, but more beneficiaries were from, of course, Indian Administrative Services, which is IAS.
So, Shyamlal, can you talk a bit about your experience investigating this story? I mean, how many RTIs did you have to file, and was it difficult getting responses, or did you have to wait for a long time?
In fact, you know that I use RTI very frequently to investigate several stories. I have filed several thousand of RTI applications in last 16 years to get some information from the government about our stories. That is another matter. But for this story, first RTI I filed in Department of Public Enterprises, and there is one Public Enterprises Selection Board. So both of them, I filed an RTI. My question was different. I asked, because you know that social inclusion is now a key term used in every government department. And like our government also, their motto is Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. So my first query was that I wanted to see whether there is socially every section is included in those directorships, because this is entirely different type of thing. So my first question to those departments, means PESP and DPE, was provide me the total number of independent directors appointed in central public sector undertakings along with their name, social category, means SC, ST, OBC, etc., and gender. So that was my first query. So what they forwarded it to number of administrative ministries which govern those PSUs, different PSUs. But proper information did not come. Some PSUs provided me the information, some did not provide. I spoke to several officers personally that what is happening. They personally advised me that you should see website. Some of the PSUs have details of their independent directors. So how my whole idea was changed that because being a reporter since last 25 years, I recognized several names, politicians and all that. So I found that several BJP leaders are there on the websites. So I started prepare the list of those individuals whose independent directors, whom I thought they are associated with ruling party. Then once the list was prepared, and I must tell you that I selected only the independent directors who was presently on the post. Somebody is retired, the tenure is ended in January 2021, so I left them. So I selected only the names, only the independent directors who are presently on a post. So that is only 172 number is there. Otherwise, they have a tenure of 3 years. So every month, some independent directors, their tenure is ended as per their appointment time, etc. So further investigation was, I then made a search from Google, from their Twitter profiles, their other social media profile, their Facebook, everything. I spent several weeks to get the related information, and then the whole list was prepared, and I found that there are 86 names, which are, I found several names that found they were office bearers of BJP or related to BJP. So finally, I got ready my list. And after that, as a matter of principle in the Indian Express reporting, you know that we must approach to everybody for their comments. So finally, I requested all of them through phone, through email. I found their whatever contact. I found everybody I approached, and I found comments from majority of them. You must have seen the story.
So can you tell us, how did they respond to you?
I can tell you, in fact, when we contact for the version of the persons whom we are mentioning in the story, sometimes it is a challenge for us that they should not catch my idea. Because for these stories to whom preparation takes several months, so it creates problem. So whenever I contacted them, my first priority was to confirm about their association with the ruling party. So I started talking about something, what is happening, this, that, so how you are associated with BJP, so you are having this post, that post. So after that, I asked that I am doing a story on independent directors of various PSUs. So many of them are related to parties, BJP also, you are also. So is there any conflict of interest you felt while functioning as independent director, all that? So my whole idea was that first I should be confirmed that, because I don't rely on social media, there may be wrong information. So my first priority was to confirm whether they are associated with BJP or not, whether the designation mentioned on the social media is correct or not. Then a confirmation I needed that they are working in the PSU. So some of them were very excited. They said, I recommended that, and the board accepted my recommendation, this, that. So that is how I prepared my questions, how I should ask them. And after getting their response, brief of their reply was prepared. But I did not receive any bad response, which happens in some stories. But here, most of them cooperated and they responded my queries.
Like Shyamlal mentioned earlier, in 2007, Indian Express had found similar things going on under the UPA government. A PIL was even filed based on our report, saying that the appointment of independent directors on the boards of public sector banks was not being done on merit, but to favor politicians connected to the Congress and its allies. The Gujarat High Court had dismissed the concern and stated, and I'm quoting, "Primary consideration of the government should be the interest of public sector banks, its depositors, and not the interest of nominees or any other vested interest." We are sure that the government will give serious thought in the future so unnecessary criticism could be avoided. Unquote. Now coming back to Shyamlal. Finally, Shyamlal, can you reiterate briefly, why does having independent directors with political affiliation not work in the interest of the growth of public sector undertakings or PSUs?
The government is run by the ruling party, you know, party leaders are there to run the government. So either they should change the name of directors and they should remove the independent from there, or they should have a policy or guideline that that persons affiliated with ruling party will not be appointed as independent directors, because these huge money is involved. You know that Maharatna companies, the basic criteria is that they must have 25,000 crore per annum turnover for last 3 years. That is the basic criteria of getting category of Maharatna. Then there are Navratna companies, there are number of loss-making companies. So they need high-ranking professionals to run the companies. The independent directors must not be appointed from the pool of political leaders. And political posts are already there. Minister is always a political person. He is the head of the administrative ministry. You know that. So when you need, where you need professionals, the key role these independent directors have in their boards, in their management and policy making of the PSU, I think they will not remain independent as long as they are associated with the ruling party. So there must be some sort of Lakshman Rekha guideline to stop this tradition, which is going on since several decades.
It is true that there were reforms under the NDA government that came in 2014, and several red flags in some form or the other were raised. In 2017, a government-mandated committee under Uday Kotak submitted a report which stated that there needs to be a continuous assessment of the independence criteria when it comes to independent directors. It said that this evaluation of independence should entail both objective and subjective assessments. Again, in 2018, a Parliamentary Standing Committee on Industry headed by RCP Singh recommended that a scrupulous mechanism for performance evaluation of independent directors has to be brought in with urgent priority. The committee also recommended that the Department of Public Enterprises shall initiate an exercise to contemporarily recast the eligibility conditions for independent directors. However, none of these committees explicitly said that independent directors should not have any links to political parties. And of course, the latest red flag when it comes to this issue is Indian Express's own investigation. So will the government pay heed this time? Well, that remains to be seen. You were listening to Three Things by the Indian Express. Today's show was written and produced by me, Snigdha Sharma, and was edited and mixed by Suresh Pawar. You can follow us and leave us feedback on Facebook or Twitter at Express Podcasts, or send us an email at podcasts@indianexpress.com. And if you like this show, please do subscribe and leave us a review wherever you get your podcast from, so more people can find us. You can also look for us in the audio section in the top right corner of our website, indianexpress.com.